I just do all the things. Hi everyone, it's Roberta with Happy on the Homefront. Thanks for joining me today. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new and you're already a subscriber, welcome back. Thanks so much for joining me on this YouTube journey of sharing my home, my heart, my faith, as I tackle everyday life as a stay-at-home mom and homeschool teacher to my children, wife, and keeper of the home, and keeper of the pets, and keeper of all the stuff. I just do all the things. Hi everyone, welcome back to Happy on the Homefront. My name is Roberta. If you're not already a subscriber, please hit that subscribe button down below and the little bell beside it. And that way you'll be notified every Wednesday when I post a new video. On today's video, I'm gonna be giving my daughter Ada her very first full all over haircut. She has 3B hair. It's curly and we have been letting it grow basically her whole life. So, and she's almost 4. So stay tuned and I will show you the products that I'll be using and go step by step at how I comb and section and trim her hair all over. Thanks for watching. Okay, hello everyone, it's Roberta with Happy on the Homefront and we have a special guest with us today. We have my youngest child and she is almost 4. And today we are going to give her her very first all over haircut. Okay. Now Ada is sitting at our kitchen table. She has her iPad in front of her. Ada, please stop that, honey. Do your iPad. And I have a towel. I also have a child's sized hair cutting cape that I've had for years since her brother Ezra was little. And we are gonna put that around to keep her clean and hopefully hair free. And I'm gonna push her sleeves up. So you can still play your iPad, Ada. It just keeps the hair from getting all over your pants, okay? So here, you can still play your iPad. Let's do that. All right, so we have that ready. And then recently I purchased this on Amazon. It is one of those continuous spray water bottles. And this is great. Her hair is clean. Her daddy washed it last night in the bathtub. So I'm gonna get her hair good and wet. And this is great because you don't have to keep pressing the pumping lever. Ada's hair is curly and it's relatively thick. Her hair's kind of fine. Mine was too when I was little. So I would say if you're talking about like hair characteristics, her hair would be a 3B. So very soon. Almost done, but you want to get it good and saturated. Okay, all right. Now, I also have just a basic Conair comb. I got a 2-pack of these at Walmart recently because our dog chewed up the other one we had. That was, I think, pretty much just like this. Okay, and I'm just gonna very gently comb out Ada's hair. Just kind of straight down to see what we have here. Okay. And back here is the part that is tangly and snarly just because it gets a lot of friction on her pillow when she sleeps at night. So, and that's really the main reason I'm cutting her hair, because this part is just really dry and snarly and it actually gets little knots in it, like individual strands are knotted up. So. Ada also has 2 cowlicks in her crown, just like her daddy. And so I'll be trying to just accommodate those. But last night on Pinterest, I looked up some ways to part hair and section hair off for an all-over layered cut. Her curls look the best when they're, you know, just like they grow naturally, kind of a layered look. So, all right, what I'm gonna do next is try to section her hair very gently into about 5 sections. That is my goal. Okay, and I saw this on Pinterest. Okay, and then I'm just going to try to, I do not have any butterfly clips of any kind, so I just got some of my barrettes out, and I'm just going to clip them like this. Okay, so I can work with one section at a time. Is that scribbles and ink? I need to put your head up, honey. There you go, thank you. Mommy's now just putting parts of your hair in little barrettes so it doesn't all get in the way of the hair that Mommy's cutting first. Okay, and I'm just gonna do that. You could certainly use butterfly clips if you have them. I did not, I don't have any. And I did not plan ahead to buy any, so. Okay, now I'm going to continue this and make a crown section.
Very artistic.
That's hopefully going to encompass her cowlix. Good girl. You're being a really good girl, Ada. Thank you. Thank you for being a good little girl, sitting so still. Okay, now Ada, can you look that way a little bit? So I've got kind of another section here for her crown.
Let's explore the planet.
And I will move the camera here in just a second.
No one's ever seen before.
And I'm trying to be very gentle with the tooth of the comb on Ada's scalp, because she really does not care for that feeling of the comb on her. Okay, now I'm going to put this into probably 3 more sections if I can. Then I'm just sort of twisting that and then securing it kind of like a loop. And I'm gonna see if y'all can see a little bit better if I put this on a chair. Let me show you the scissors that I have. They're the same ones that I use in the video where I cut my own hair. They are from Sally Beauty Supply, and the brand is From, F-R-O-M-M, okay? But they do have an adjustable screw in the middle. My daughter-in-law said that was very important. They do have a finger rest, okay, and a stop, and they are very sharp. I have already cut myself once, okay? So now, I'm just going to start back here where I take sections of the section, and I'm just going to pull it straight out and try to trim that Ada. And I wish we had a stool, because this is kind of in my way, the back of the chair, but I'm going to see if I can scoot her forward a little bit and get more room between her hair and this thing that's in my way. Okay, so here we go. And I'm just going to be taking off. And I'm going to see if I can zoom you in a little bit. Sugar booger. All right, play Daniel Tiger.
And here it comes back to me.
Okay, and I'm just going to be taking off those uneven ends. Those are just falling right on her little booster seat for the table. But I can just vacuum that right up. I have my vacuum cleaner right over there.
Margaret likes playing with her big brother.
I think I'm taking off about 3/4 of an inch, just the ends of the curls.
The fish can squirt.
That are uneven. When you pull them out, and if your child has curly hair like mine, it's gonna wrap around your finger, and that's fine. I'm just trying not to cut myself because it hurts. It might taste good. I'm gonna check it this way. Let's see if I did pretty good. I see a long piece over here.
We gotta try new food, cause it might taste
Ada, can you put your head down, honey?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Ada, can you bend your head down? Ada, can you bend your head down for mommy? Thank you.
Stop and listen to Stacy.
Okay, I think I'm almost done. This part. Done. Ada, turn this way just a second, honey, so they can see the back of your hair. Turn your head this way. Very pretty. Okay, good job. Thank you.
I like the ponies on these.
Do you?
And also the green things.
What are those green things?
Tell me what they are.
I think they're called aliens. They like are space things. They live in space.
I love singing with you.
It's almost time to stop.
So she's one more thing to do. Okay, we'll take this section down. And we will.
Why are you pulling my little paper?
I'm not pulling, honey. I'm combing to get them nice and straight. So they'll be pretty when mommy.
You gotta try new food because it might taste good.
That's it. Now you can see all of that. What is Daniel eating? And then, when you get to the very top section of your child's hair, the top of their head, the crown, and the top surface of the head, you're going to pull the hair straight up. And that will be a 90 degree angle. Two sections left. Okay, honey. This little front side section, and then the top.
Can you first help me test out the game? Then, can you try to build your own levels?
See how that's curling around?
Needs to survive. Some animals are looking for food. Which animal do you want to be. Blue crab, grab! Do you want this level to be easy or hard? You can also make your own level. Stay away from animals that might eat you. Find this much food.
Hair's starting to dry out, so I am trying to hurry because I don't want to have to re-wet it. There's no problem in re-wetting it, but she just really doesn't like it, so I'm trying to hurry.
You got it. Try again or make your own level. Little crab, grab.
Easy. There you go. Good job. Yeah.
Find this much food.
Don't want to get eaten.
Tap to go down.
Some things I missed there. Whoops, just about cut my finger again. Crab, grab. Oh, is he grabbing stuff? The little crab? Okay, I'm going to try to blend these two sections together a little bit. Okay. Okay, we're almost done.
What is that? Okay, Ada, can you look up at the camera? Do you look up there? Look up there. All done! All done, sugar bugger! All done! I'm making some funny faces.
Yeah, you can make some funny faces. All done! Thanks so much for watching, everyone. I hope this video has been a blessing to you and a help and has given you some confidence and encouragement that you can cut your own children's hair, especially if you just do a basic 90 degree from the head cut, just an all over trim. If you have any questions at all, please leave them in the comments below and I will get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe that red button below and hit that bell. I'd appreciate it. So, today was haircut day at our house. I gave 4 haircuts. My husband, my son, I cut my own hair, and then my daughter's. So today, all in all, we saved between $85 and $100. My haircut would have cost the most. And so that's just a real blessing to me. And these scissors that I bought have already paid for themselves 2 or 3 times. So anyway, if you have any questions at all, please hit me up in the comments below, and I will see you for a new video next Wednesday. Thank you so much for joining me today for another video. Please subscribe and hit the little bell so that you are notified every Wednesday when I upload a new video.